On March 19, 2022, a swarm of earthquakes began underneath the island of Sao Jorge and its volcano in the Portuguese Azores island chain. Although earthquakes are quite common in this island chain, it is rare for them to occur in such great numbers. Over the next 24 hours, more than 700 earthquakes occurred, dozens of which were large enough to be felt by the local populace. These quakes occurred on the west-central portion of the island, which just happened to be where the island's most recent eruption was in 1808. As a result, some third-party sites unofficially raised the volcano's alert level from green to yellow. So, is an eruption likely? What is the context of these earthquakes? This video will answer these two questions and discuss what might happen next at Sao Jorge. For some context, the island of Sao Jorge is located 1,600 kilometers west of mainland Portugal. This island has an unusual shape, measuring 53 kilometers long and 8 kilometers wide. Its coastlines are defined by more than 300-meter or 1,000-foot-tall sheer cliffs which surround the island. The weird shape of this island is owed due to the nature of volcanic activity which formed it. Unlike the nearby Mount Pico volcano to the south, this island is not a stratovolcano. Instead, it is a massive fissure system. In fissure systems, eruptions occur when the fissure system widens, allowing for magma to intrude into the crust and eventually erupt onto the surface. This type of volcanism is most frequently seen at or near mid-ocean ridges, and this is no exception. The island of Sao Jorge is located adjacent to the Atlantic mid-ocean ridge, where, like many of its adjacent islands, it lies in a lengthy transform fault. This fault defines the shape of the island as it marks a path of least resistance for molten rock that intrudes underneath the island to erupt from. The several hundred earthquakes which have occurred so far have been defined by a west-northwest trending pattern. Since the tectonic faults on Sao Jorge perfectly align with the shape any intrusion of magma would take, it makes differentiating between the two quite difficult. Although the quakes started across a broader area, they have since migrated increasingly towards the area just north of the town of Veas. Each historical volcanic eruption of the complex began with a similar series of earthquakes to what is ongoing right now. For example, a series of earthquakes which occurred in 1964 resulted in a one-day-long eruption at a submarine vent 4 kilometers southwest of the island's coastline. Although the ongoing earthquakes were just determined to be completely tectonic in origin, this is a misleading statement. A magma chamber exists underneath the island, and significant fault movement could widen or change the overlying faults and fissures just enough that an eruption is triggered. Thus, while the odds of an eruption are difficult to quantify, they are in the low double-digit percentage range at the present. I even ran a satellite dataset to check for uplift indicating the intrusion of fresh magma, but luckily found none, although this could change. If an eruption was to occur, it would most likely follow a pattern of the island's 7 prior eruptions. 5 of these eruptions occurred at 2 separate submarine vents, one to the southwest of the island and one to the east. Each of these eruptions lasted less than 24 hours. As for the 2 eruptions which occurred on the island, each eruption was defined by the opening of a several kilometer long fissure, resulting in lengthy fields of lava which flowed towards the coastline. These eruptions primarily created cinder cones through Strombolian-style volcanic activity, which is defined by the intermittent ejection of ash and bombs of lava. However, due to the abundant groundwater in the area, the 2 historical eruptions in 1580 and 1808 were also quite deadly, as they produced pyroclastic flows. These pyroclastic flows were triggered by phreatomagmatic explosions, that is, the interaction of magma with groundwater. The heated groundwater flashed to steam and exploded, releasing 100 km/h flow of lethal superheated gases. I have marked on screen where the pyroclastic flows traveled during those eruptions with orange arrows. If an eruption was to occur, it would not be safe to be within a 3 km radius of an erupting fissure or within a 5 km radius downslope of a vent. Although warning signs are not currently pointing towards an eruption, we are still monitoring the ongoing situation. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new patron Richard Bergen for supporting this channel.